So this is English 1010 with Mr. Smith. I'm talking about the profile paper. A dominant impression is sometimes created through paraphrase, and where you are still referencing your research, but you're describing them. And if you have the opportunity to observe your interviewee in any way or shape or form, this will be gratefully advantageous to you. So for example, in this passage, Wilson, known around town as Professor Dumpster, recounted in another recent interview that he now owns 4 pairs of pants, 4 shirts, 3 pairs of shoes, 3 hats, and in keeping with his hipster-esque aesthetic, 8 or 9 bow ties. So you can describe what the interviewee is like, because that helps convey the dominant impression. A quote sandwich is where you quote the most memorable quotes. That's what you're gonna do with this interview. You're gonna take the quotes from the interview, and you're gonna find those that are most memorable, and you're gonna place them in the paper. You're not gonna end up using all of the quotes in the paper itself, but maybe approximately 3 quotes would be an excellent idea. Wilson's most anticipated upcoming boon is a toilet. I'm not as concerned about the shower, he said, but getting to the toilet sometimes requires a midnight run. Currently, he uses facilities at the university's gym. So here's a quote, very memorable, very vivid, embedded inside the body of a paper. The importance of the quote sandwich is to give credit to the person you're quoting, but also not to leave your reader at wondering where this quote is coming from, who's speaking, why it's placed in the paper, when it's placed there at that given time. And so a quote sandwich helps us avoid the hit and run quotation, sometimes called the plop, where you just drop a quote in there, or where it's unclear to the reader why you are quoting, or even that you're quoting. It can sometimes come off as rude to the reader. So a good quote sandwich begins with a setup sentence that gives the context of the quote and the relevant of the quote and leads into the quotation. A signal phrase such as Smith said, comma, quote, always use a quote sandwich. And then there's a follow-up sentence after the quote that packages it. That's the bottom piece of bread. So the top piece of bread is the setup sentence, including the signal phrase. The meat of the sandwich is the quote itself, and then the follow-up is the bottom piece of bread. Signal phrase includes the name of the person speaking, the interviewee, the actual quote itself. The follow-up sentence gives some commentary or explanation. The best quotes that you're going to use in a paper are going to be extremely short, extremely relevant, and in memorable language. Other information about your interviewee will still end up in the paper, but it'll be used through paraphrase and through summary. A quote sandwich will support your text in the right place at the right time. It will guide the reader in and out of the quote. It will show who is speaking with the author's name and a strong signal verb, and it will explain what the quote means. And then sometimes you might want to pick different phrases besides said. You can say declared or emphasized or promised and so on and so forth. There's many different active voice verbs that you can use as a signal verb in addition to said or says. And you will decide in your paper whether you want to use past or present tense for your signal verbs, and you'll stick to that for the duration of the paper. This is an overlapping paper between an English paper and a journalism paper. In journalism, they tend to use said and the past tense only. In an English paper, they tend to use present tense, place the signal phrase before the quotation, and they tend to use more than just the word said. This is a profile about Newhall North. Pre-med major Sidney McCormick is a freshman here at Tech. So you named who you're talking to in first name and last name, said where the context is, and then you have their name. McCormick emphasizes that's the signal phrase, and then she gives a quote to talk about why she likes Newhall North, and then there's a follow-up to that. So that's an example of how to do the signal phrases and embed the quotes within a paragraph. Putting the quotes in the paper is not that hard to do, but it's very, very important that you learn how to do it correctly. Whenever you directly quote a source or paraphrase their statements, you need to acknowledge their words by citing your source. In the case of a personal interview, you will show your citation as follows. Interviewee's name, last name, comma, first name, period. Personal interview, period, and the date that the interview was conducted. Day, first month, and the year. This will be for the works cited entry of the profile paper. So here's some examples of what that would look like. Last name, McCormick. First name, Michael. Personal interview and the date. And so on and so forth. So this is a great little introduction to, once you've done the interview, how you take the quotes out of the interview and you put them in to the paper. So just to review, you're going to have a quote sandwich that has a top piece of bread getting you ready for the quote. The quote itself is the meat after the signal phrase, and then the follow-up sentence after, and that's your bread. The signal phrase and the follow-up. Then you have the actual tofu of the situation, the actual cheese and tomato and lettuce of the situation is short, relevant, and memorable language. So that's just a little bit of extra on how we're going to move from move the interview towards the actual paper itself with placing the